friends, welcome back to our channel. So in our this is the second part of our how to take the driving license in Germany video. So in the last video I was telling about I will show you some real life scenarios like what we are facing in day-to-day life and what we need to really check, what we need to really care once we are taking the practical examinations. So I think instead of speaking, maybe it is better to show you directly in the road. So we'll see the remaining things in the road directly. See you, bye.
We will start with the first scenario, always using right lane. Normally, if you have more lanes, like more than one lane, then the leftmost lane can be only used for overtaking purpose. But in cities and all, you can see that people will be using both lanes. But officially, this is the rule, and while taking the practical examination, you should follow this rule because the instructor or the examiner will be checking all these things while we are following or not. And then always keep an eye on the traffic signal also. In this scenario, you can see that the traffic signal was changing to yellow. In this case, you should not accelerate the vehicle because you have enough distance to stop it. Of course, if your vehicle is very close to traffic signal, you can just pass. But if you have enough distance like that 20-30 meters, then you should stop it. That's mandatory. We will look into another example of stopping a traffic signal. So normally there will be a big white line in front of the traffic signal and you should stop just before the line. Actually, you are not allowed to cross that line because that is like a safety point they will be keeping it, and we should stop just before the straight line. Another main reason for stopping here it is, from here you have a clear visibility of the traffic lights and you should start your vehicle only if the traffic signal turns into green. Should not start the vehicle once it is reaching to yellow. Should always wait until it is getting green. The main thing is with the cycle path. You are not allowed to enter on the cycle path. In city centers and all, you can see that they marked this cycle path with a red color, but not everywhere they marked with a red color. Even though if it is not marked as red, you are not allowed to enter on the cycle path. This is very important thing because it is a safety critical issue. The next main point is priority. Always keep in mind that the rule right before left, which means people coming from the right side, they have more priority than people coming from the left side. In this scenario, you can see that there is a road from right side, so you should stop or slow down and check there is nobody coming from the car from that side. If someone is coming, you should stop and you should allow them to pass. There is another scenario. I wanted to take a left turn, but there is a cyclist coming and there is a right side road. So I need to wait until the cyclist is gone and then I need to check if someone is coming from right side. If nobody is coming, then only I should take a left turn. Another scenario, there is a right turn, but it is a Einbahnstraße, so which means it's a one way. So logically I can say that nobody will come from that side. But if you are taking a driving test, I will say you should stop or reduce the speed there and check it. But yeah, logically you can say nobody will come. But in this case, you can see there is a minus symbol, so which means people will be coming from there. You are not allowed to enter, so people will come from there. So you should stop in that case. Now the another scenario. This right before left rule will not be applicable if you are on a priority road. You can see this priority symbol on the road, and normally you will be learning all the priority symbols for your theoretical examinations. Another main point in the priority is that give way or the stop and go symbol. Normally, if you see these symbols, then you should stop there and give priority to the other people coming in front of the road. Priority is that allowing pedestrians to cross the road, because pedestrians have higher rights than us, so that we should allow them to cross the road. Another important priority, once we are in a mandatory work area, the yellow lines. If you see any yellow lines, you need to follow the yellow lines only, not the white lines. And second thing is that if you're driving on the yellow line area, there will be a speed limit that will be sure you need to always follow the speed limit. And another one more thing is that while driving this area, this will be a bit confusing because you will be having a white line and you will be having a yellow line. So you need to always take care while driving here and go slowly. And in this yellow line area, the width of the road also will be less actually. Another safety critical issue is that the shoulder blink. If you are going to take a right turn or any turn, normally if you are waiting in a signal, then there are like a lot of blind spot in for our vehicle and we cannot see the people who are standing or coming standing nearby our car. Some blind spots are there. So here we should always do a shoulder blink, like you need to turn back right side or left side, and then only you should take the car. This is a very important thing while driving the car because it is like we can save one person's life because of doing this one, and make this as a practice always while driving the car or any vehicle basically. And if you miss this to do this for some time, if you miss this at least one time also, then you are disqualified immediately for the test. In this example, you can see that we are waiting in a traffic signal and there are a lot of cyclists coming in the same direction. And if you are in a front side and they are just stopping just before the right side mirror, then we cannot see them through the mirror because that is a blind spot. And while doing the shoulder blink, then you can see that people are waiting them and we can wait until them pass through, and then only we should start the car. And another scenario here, you can see that there is a yellow light blinking in the right side. So which means that there are people crossing through the street, so that we should be very careful. And if there is nobody crossing, then only we should pass. Here is another example. You can see we are waiting in a signal and then the traffic light is going to turn green, and immediately there you can see that there is a cyclist passing through that one. Then in this case, if you are taking a right turn and if you are not doing a shoulder blink, then we will definitely hit that person. So this is the reason that we need to do always this shoulder blink before taking it. The next one is the roundabout. So while entering the roundabout, we need to always check that if anybody is already there in the roundabout. If someone is there, they already have the priority. And we should not put an indicator while entering the roundabout. We should put all indicator once we are exiting from the roundabout. This we need to take care of. Now we will see the scenarios driving in cities. So normally city driving will be a bit some more difficult because we will be having more traffic, then we will be having more people will be in the road, like on the roadside, or people will be crossing in the main city centers and all. Then we'll be having more traffic lights, more cyclists, and then we have a big buildings or something, so there are a lot of distractions are there. So always in the city you need to concentrate while driving. This is one thing. Second thing is that in the city, the speed limit is reduced to 40 km per hour. This is something you need to always check once driving in the city. So most of the places, they will be already updated with the city speed limit, with the 40 km per hour speed limit. But this you should keep in mind. Normally it will be 50 in other places, but in city center, it will be 40 km per hour. So this you should keep in mind. Show you a really dangerous situation here. I wanted to take a right turn here, and you can see that there are cycle paths. One is here, and then there are another cycle path which is coming from the other side of the road. So which means there are two cycle paths, and we need to take a right turn here. We need to, even though the traffic signal will be turn into green, then the cyclist also will start coming, and there will be a pedestrians which is crossing because it is a city center. And here we should be very careful before taking that turn. We need to always do a shoulder break and take very, very slowly because there are really, really a dangerous situation. So this always, like in these situations, you should be very patient and take very slowly the car, and you need to watch very carefully all the roads, like all the cyclists which is coming from here or the other side, because you cannot see everything properly, so you need to do very carefully here. While driving on a narrow road, here we should be very careful because the width of the road will be very small and both sides maybe the vehicles will be available, and if you make a small scratch also it will be really a problem. And ideally you should drive very slowly here and very carefully. And in this case there is a cycle path also there, which means if there is cyclist coming opposite to me, I should give a preference or priority to him, so I should stop there and then wait and let them pass, and then only I should drive. So while driving on narrow road, we should be very careful and go slowly. Other criteria or some scenarios will come maybe while taking test or while driving in the car in Germany, which is one is called tram road. So while driving in tram road, you should be very careful for one thing, which is called slippery. If your tire is going inside the tram lane, the tire may get slippery, and if it is in winter time, it will be like slippery, will be like more slip, it will be like more slippery actually. And if you are driving in the tram, the signals also will be like much more, there will be some other signals also will be there, and there will be like more places will be having no stopping zone or something like that. So these all things you need to take care, and while taking a test also you should be always consider these things actually. Now we will talk about parking. So the main scenario mostly we will face is the parallel parking. So in cities or mostly in a place where we wanted to do a parking, there will not be having enough space, and we most of the times we wanted to do the parallel parking only. Unfortunately, I was not able to take a video from outside because it was a bit busy road, but yeah, it is not so difficult. You need to practice a bit, and this is one of the important criteria while doing the practical test also. One simple trick here you can follow is that if you have a reference car, always try to align the car with the mirror to mirror, so that your mirror and the other car mirror is almost same time, and the length of the car is almost same, then it is a very easy method for you to park. For the driving test, you need to do one more parking, which is called reverse parking. Normally we will be do this in the parking lot of a supermarket or something. You need to do the reverse parking. Unfortunately, I don't have a video of that. I forgot to take that one. But this is also one thing they will be checking it once we are doing a practical examination. Next scenario is the night driving. Normally, while taking the driving lessons, this scenario will not come. We can say that night driving is not there because the test will be in daytime. But I will say that there is some cases. For example, if you're taking an exam is on winter time, and then if you're taking exam like afternoon or something, then maybe suddenly we get a dark, and then these conditions will come. Like it will not be completely dark, but still it will be much darker. So while driving in night, there is no special rule or something. Only thing is like we should be very careful because the visibility will be very less, or visibility will be less. And second problem is like we'll be always having the reflection issue, like you will be having more glare in your windscreen and all. So you will be having more reflections and other issues, and the visibility will be less. And if it is winter, then it will be like a bit hard because you cannot really see anything. It will be like really hard. So while driving at night, you should be driving very carefully. Other than that, there is the rule side, everything is same, so nothing special. And one more thing, while driving in night, you need to remember that using the high beam. So using high beam is not allowed in here Germany, but it does not mean like you should never use it. For example, if you have a visibility issue, you cannot see that what is there in front of you. So then in that case, you can just use the high beam for a moment, and then you need to immediately turn it off. So you can just pass, like we can say, we can just pass and check what is there, but you should not keep the high beam on and you should not drive like that. But in newer vehicles, there are the feature like auto high beam, which means that if there is no vehicle in front of you or behind you, then the vehicle itself will be do the auto high beam. And then if there is a vehicle coming in front of you, it's like very far away itself, there will be sensor and it will be detect and it will be turn it off automatically. So in this case, it is okay because it is automatically turned it off immediately once they are seeing a vehicle. So this is okay. This is a feature provided by the manufacturer itself. But normally, if you don't have this feature, you should not keep it as like manually turning on the high beam. This is not allowed, like turning on the high beam and driving continuously, which is not allowed. The last scenario in my list is at the autobahn. So while entering the autobahn, we should always take care of that there will be a light right lane and you need to speed up in the lane and then only you need to merge at the end of the lane. So we should check that, okay, there is some no vehicle from the left side and you need to speed up at least some 70-80 kilometers. You can use your third gear and then you need to, at the end of the lane, before reaching the end of the lane, you just need to slightly merge into the autobahn. So this is something you need to take care of while always like entering the autobahn and while doing the test also. And then in the autobahn, you need to, like while taking the test, you need to drive at least 100 km per hour speed. And then you need to check always the speed limit also. If there is an area that there is a speed limit and they are telling you should not drive 100 km, you need to drive only 80, then you need to consider. Otherwise, you can drive 100 km. You don't need to drive like 200 or 150 or something like that because it's a test. So you can always concentrate on driving 100 km and then it is easy. And driving in autobahn, you need to be very careful because all the vehicles coming will be like very fast. And if you make a small mistake also, it will be, the impact will be really high. So drive very carefully and you will be having enough width and enough lane. So you can don't need to worry about much, but yeah, drive carefully. Last but not the least, the autobahn exit. So for exiting the autobahn, you need to come to the right lane well in advance so that it will be easy to go to the last lane, exiting lane. And then there will be a speed limit mentioned in the exiting lane, so you need to follow that speed limit in the curve area. And here you should reduce only your speed once you are reaching the exiting lane, and you need to immediately reduce your speed to the mentioned speed because you are coming in a high speed and the curve will be like dangerous to take in that speed. Other than the points which I mentioned before, for the while taking the practical examination, you will be having one more criteria you need to do, which is called emergency braking. Here what you need to do here, it is normally they will ask you to drive in a like an area where they will be having mostly 30 speed limit, or even if it is like a very less crowded area, they will take it normally, and they will ask you to drive in a 30 km per hour speed, and then suddenly they will tell you to do a emergency braking. And what you need to do here at that time, it is like while they're telling, immediately you need to apply your clutch and your brake with the maximum full force. So the meaning is like you need to stop as early as possible. And here also you don't need to worry much because they will tell you before itself like they are going to do this one only, like emergency braking only. So you can be prepared for that one and then only they will tell. So you don't need to worry much about this doing the examination, and they will normally check that the mirrors and all, like there is any vehicle coming in behind or something. So normally they will check everything and then only they will ask you to do this one. So you can just follow what they're telling, like you need to apply the brake, that's all. And one more simple information or trick we can follow once we are taking a driving practical examination or once we are driving in the Germany itself is like using the cruise control feature, because the speed limit is really important here once we are taking the examination or once you're driving in Germany, and the fine from the traffic violations are a bit higher and now they increased again. So for avoiding this one, you can use the cruise control feature, which is already most of the car will be having this feature. And while taking practical examinations also, you are allowed to do the, you are allowed to use the cruise control feature. There is no restriction for using it. If you can, you can use it so that you don't need to worry about the speed limit at that time while taking the examination, and you can concentrate on the other things, which will be easy for taking the test. And one more information I wanted to share with you is that there is a training area where we can rent it out for some time, and then you can do a practice there. So inside this area, you don't need a driving school instructor for making the to do the practice. You can go with one of your friends or something who already have a car, and then you can do a practice here. And in almost all cities, you can find this one. You can search, simply Google this one with your place name, and you can rent it out. It is not so high cost or something. It is almost affordable only compared to you are taking more lessons in the driving school. This is much more affordable and much more relaxed way you can do it. Only one, and here inside driving, you don't need a license because this is only like a training center, and they will be allocating you a specific location where not other people are doing it. And another advantage is like you can see a lot of traffic symbols which you are really seeing in the road. So this is like a, almost like a, you will get a feel like you're driving in the same road only. One more thing you need to keep in mind, that the once taking the practical examination, the person coming from the Führerscheinstelle, they will be speaking mostly in German only. And here what you need to do is like, once you're practicing the lessons in your driving with your driving school instructor, you it is better to practice always in German so that you can be familiar with the German words. Something like you need to take a rest or links or gerade aus or something like that. You can keep always this in mind, and then once taking the practical examination, you don't need to worry much about that at that time. And once you are taking practical examinations, normally the driving school instructors will tell like where to go, like you need to take a right or left, or if they're not telling anything, you can just go straight. That is a normal rule what they will follow it. And here sometimes they will tell that next time moglische rest or links, which means like next possible right or left. In this case, you need to always keep in mind that the very next right or left will be a single entry, like one way, and you should keep that in mind this is mostly it will be one way, and you should not enter that lane. If you enter that lane, then if you enter to the road, then you are failed. So you should always keep this in mind, and normally this is like most of the people will be telling you to do this. And while driving the car, you should always check all three mirrors, like your right mirror, left mirror, and the center mirror. Always you need to look on the mirrors, because the Führerschein inspector will be checking also this one, whether you are looking on to these things or not. This is also important. While driving the car itself, it's really important thing. You need to always look into the mirrors. And then another one more thing what they will normally tell you is like they will ask you some basic questions, like before starting the car, it's a test itself, they will be asking you where to fill this the coolant, or where to fill the engine oil, where to fill the brake oil, like that things, some small things. Mostly your driving school instructor will be telling you all these details. And normally, once we are driving the car, the inspector will be asking you to do some controls on the radio so that they can check that while driving you are not distracted by controlling something. So that kind of small things they will ask, but this on all like not a very hard thing or something, so you don't need to worry much about this one. But just keep in mind that they may be asking it, so once you are doing the practical, like practice itself, you can follow this kind of things so that it will be easy once making the practical examination. And after watching my last video, one of my friends, he informed me that there is one major thing which we can do while doing the document verification. This is right. Normally, I told we need to apply all the with all the documents in the Führerscheinstelle, and then we need to wait for 2-3 months for getting the verification done. But what he told me is like there is a possibility like we can try with the express way. So you need to pay 10 euro extra, but then you will get the documents within 1 week itself. So this is actually really good info, and thank you, Nigel John, for giving this very good information, so that we can save a lot of time. And most of the people have a doubt like the German license driving license is an international license or not. Actually, the German driving license is not an international driving license, and inside the driving license, all the fields are filled by German language only. But you can use this license throughout the European, like throughout Europe. There is no problem for using it. If there is a possibility, like you can convert this as an international license, how you can do is, like, once you have the driving license, you can go to the Führerscheinstelle and you can request for converting this to an international license. So what they will be doing is, like, they will be charging you, I think, 16 or 17 euro for that, and then they will be giving you an international license for 3 years, which means, like, they will be giving you another book, a small book kind of thing. They will be giving it, in that they will be having multiple languages, and mainly it will be in English. And you need to go with only a photograph, you need to give it, and then you need to pay the fees. And what they will be doing is, like, they will be giving you all the information what you have in your driving license to this book, and you can use this book as an international driving license. And then, of course, you need to check the other country also where you're going to drive, whether this international license is allowed or not. But this is a possibility. We can convert this driving license as an international driving license. And most of the people have another doubt also, once you're going to collect your German driving license, whether they will be taking your original license or not. If you are converting it, this is right. Once you're going to collect your German license, you need to carry your original driving license also, which you are converting or converting to the German license, and they will collect your license only. They will not give you back the license, and you will be having only the German driving license. So here there is a problem. Even in my case also, my driving license, I have a motorbike plus I have the car license, but here I don't take the motorbike, and here I have already car. But in this case also, they will not give you back the original license. What you already have, what is, like, my Indian license, but I have only now the German driving license. This is actually the rule or what they're following it. I think that's all, friends. I tried to cover as much as information possible and as much as scenarios possible. I hope I covered all the required informations. And most of the people, it is a dream to get a German driving license. And I wish you everyone a very best success, and hope everyone can pass the examination within the first attempt itself. So thank you for watching the video. If you like the video, please hit the like button and share the video to your friends so that it will be helpful for others. And if you like the content from our channel, then please subscribe also. And if I miss something or if you have any questions, please comment on the video so that it will be useful for others also. Then have a nice day. See you guys. Bye.